Hello and welcome to another video about technical analysis. So in today's tutorial, we want to talk about moving averages. Moving averages are one of the indicators that I prefer to use in my trading and investing strategy, and they are very important for myself. And as I said before, on this channel, we start with the basics and then we start to form systems and then we will get to more advanced stuff. But we need to get the basics right because we can then build on this foundation. So today we are going to talk about moving averages. So before we start, it is important that you understand when to use moving averages because they don't work in all market conditions. Sometimes they work and sometimes not. Sometimes the price respects moving averages and sometimes the price doesn't. And it's just important to understand when that is the case. And I will talk about that in this video. And also it's important to understand that the moving average, there are different moving averages, yeah, different period moving averages, that these are only indicators, yeah, they indicate, and you should always use them together with other indicators or other factors in your analysis. Don't use them necessarily as a standalone tool because that could potentially lead you to wrong conclusions. And then there are different period moving averages. So we've got a 20 period moving average, a 50 period moving average, a 100 day and 200 day. There are also all sorts of different moving averages. You can even create your own one. And what the moving average is, it's basically the average price over a certain period. So for example, over the last 20 day period, it will produce a shorter term average price. So the shorter the period is, the more affected is the moving average by price volatility, and we will show you that in this video. Also, when you do your analysis, I think very important is just to stay consistent. I mean, there are different ones. In which one is the best? You know, you've got popular ones are like the 9, 20, 50, 100, and 200. But you know, which one is the best? In my opinion, there is no best moving average. It all depends on your own strategy. And I prefer to use a 20, 50, and 100. No, sorry, 20, 50, and 200. But it's all about staying consistent. I think as long as you find the ones that work for you and you stay consistent, that should be fine. As said before, that the length of the moving average really determines how sensitive the moving average is. So if you have a 20 moving average, it is more volatile than a 50-day moving average, for example. So for me, there is really no right or wrong into which you can take, but we are going to show you that in this video. And what actually is the purpose of the moving average? So for me, the moving average really shows you or gives you an indication of the trend, the way in which the price is moving. There are certain crossovers that can happen, which then can help you identify a change in direction. So you also get an understanding about the strength of a certain trend. And also it allows you to identify potentially when a price might move in the other direction. So let's take a look at how to actually add moving averages. You can see I've got a chart here at the moment with a 20-day moving average, which is the blue line. To do our analysis, I always prefer to have at least two moving averages. So we're currently here on the 1 hour chart. So you do this in TradingView, which is the tool that I'm using here, indicators and strategies. Just type in moving average and select it. Then there will be a moving average be added to your chart. And then you can just click on this button here and change the length to 50. And then we've got a 20 and a 50-day moving average. We can see that the 50 has the green color and the 20 has the blue color. Now you can already see that there are various crossovers here. There's one here, there's one here, there's another one here actually. There is one here, one up here, one more here, and then one more here at the end. So what this setup can tell you is where to enter a long position, for example, or where to enter a short position. So that's how many traders are doing it. So because the 20-day moving average is moving quicker than the 50-day moving average, there are various areas of crossover. So I'm just going to mark them here. One area of crossover, another one, there's one here, one here, one here, one here, one here. And we're going to take a look at, you know, if you had used this indicator now to enter, for example, a long or a short position, would that have made you any money? So let's take a look at the first crossover here. indicating that bullish crossover where the shorter term moving average is crossing over the longer term moving average. When that is taking place, it's normally a bullish, or it can be a bullish signal to, for example, enter a long trade. So let's say you had done that. Yes, you could have made some money because the price went up from down here to up here. Then there's a bearish crossover. So had you gone just to short this, you wouldn't really have, well, you actually would have, potentially if you had shorted here already, you could have entered that downtrend here very early. However, there was another bullish crossover here, and it was a bit difficult. They were touching here at least, not really a crossover, but they were touching. So, however, if you had entered a short position, then yeah, you could have made some money here as well. Now the price started to go up, but only here you saw another bullish crossover where the shorter term moving average crossed the longer term moving average. And yes, had you entered the trade here, you could have made some money. There was another bearish crossover here, so here you wouldn't have made any money, right? Because the price was actually going up still. It was only a short term downtrend, or you would have had to be very quick and very careful. Maybe you could have broken even or something, but then here another bullish crossover. So you could have entered here. But then again, if you see here where we were when the bearish crossover happened, the price was already down here. So here, because of the speed in which the price went up and down, you were probably too late, right? So just let me repeat that. Bullish crossover here, you entered the trade here, long position, you went up here. The price couldn't make any new highs, yeah? So losing momentum, but it was the price were already, it was already nearly down here again already, but the crossover only happened here. So it would have indicated you too late that it's time to sell, or that you have to enter a short position. Well, but then again, this is all down to, you know, don't only use the moving averages in themselves, also combine them with other indicators or other, you know, just way how to read charts. You know, you need to understand, for example, when a price is losing momentum. And I showed you some ways of doing that in the last video. So this is just one indicator, but it can work, as we already saw here. It would have helped you here, would have helped you here, would have helped you here, and only here it wouldn't have helped you. But again, here it would have helped you, and here as well, right? So very interesting, and just these can work. But then with this setup here that I've just shown you, where you would have been too late, well, that's where it's potentially clever to add another moving average. For example, we are now on the 1 hour chart, bear that in mind. So when you're on the 1 hour chart, it might have been clever to use a 9 day moving average as well, which is now the yellow line that you can see here. And what we can see is that this yellow line produced a bearish crossover here much earlier. So we can actually move that blue line over here. So it was still not early enough, but it would have been earlier. But still, it wouldn't have helped you here. But I just want to show you that they are quicker, the shorter term moving averages, and they could have potentially helped you to avoid false signals. So always use various indicators. But in most cases, I think the 20, 50 and 100 or 200 should work well. At least it works for me. I rarely use the 9 day moving average. But yeah, if you trade in very short time frames, that might help you as well. But so it's all about staying consistent. And one more thing that I would like to show you is really what is often referred to as a pullback. When you, for example, have your price bouncing back onto a moving average. So let me just take out maybe the 9 again and the 20. So we just have the 50 left here. And what you can see here, we were in a sort of uptrend here. Yeah, the price even crossed the moving average to the upside. And then the price pulled back onto the moving average. This is oftentimes when many people, maybe just like short-term trader, enter a trade. When they then see that there's a green candle taking place, yeah, and this could be the opening of a long position, until then the price moves some momentum and they sell. But the pullback to a moving average can be considered a good entry position. For example, here, had you entered here in that pullback, wait maybe a few green candles and get confirmation that yes, we are not breaking to the downside, but we bounce off, then this could have been a really nice trade until it's losing momentum, no new higher high. Yeah, so even had you left here where you had could have seen, okay, no new higher high, I exit the trade, then you could have made some money. That's one way of doing it. And This is often referred as a pullback, and it works either way. So in an uptrend or in a downtrend, where again here in the downtrend, the price was pulling back to the moving average. And if we now, for example, add again a moving average, so for example, a longer term one. So if I just add another moving average here, now we've got the 9 and the 50. No, let's just add maybe the 200. So what I often use is the 50 and the 200. And what you can see here that you get really very different signals. And it, you know, it's not better or worse, but it just shows you just different signals. And especially here on the 1 hour time frame, maybe it wouldn't work that well, the longer term one, but maybe the 200 day moving average and the 50 might work better on a daily chart or a weekly chart, yeah? But it just gives you completely different signals. I think normally when you let's go back maybe to a daily chart, so if this works on all time frames, but what we can see here, that we had the daily chart and that we've really for a very long time have been since here, where has the 50-day moving average been above the 200-day moving average, and it hasn't even crossed the 200 moving average to the downside. So we've always been above it, right? Traveled with the price, and now we're in a steep uptrend here. So one more thing I'd like to show you actually is I would like to recommend that you only use moving averages which are really respected by the market. So let's just pick a moving average which is very short. So for example, just the 9-day moving average or the 10-day, but you can actually see this is not really working very well because just using the 9-day moving average, it is so volatile, and you can see how on the hourly chart, this is really just, there's the price is constantly swinging around this 9-day moving average. It's very hard to make out support and resistance levels here. So that's what traders generally call it's not respected by the market. It's just the wrong moving average for this time frame. You could potentially use it together with a 20 to find some crossovers, but to use it as support or resistance level, it is a bit hard. It sometimes works like here as a support, but then it crosses very often. It crosses very often, especially here. So in this market condition here, it doesn't really work. So if that takes place, I encourage you maybe to use another one, maybe one like 20, which works much better here because you have far less crossovers and it seems to work much better. Even here, it's not great here. Even here, it's a bit difficult, but more often than not, it seems to work here as support. Here, it works as resistance level various times. Then again, here in this uptrend, it works as support. Here it works as well because it acts as a breakout. You know, it is basically the signal for the break, for the price to break out. You can clearly see that. And here it acts as, again, as support, bounces off, but it's a double top, so it breaks down. Another pullback to the moving average, breaks down again, and it works here as resistance level. So that would be a good indicator, the 20, to use here. And the 50 might work as well. So if I change that to the 50, so I can just encourage you just to try that out, not to use one which is just too low in the setting and then just doesn't work in your current time frame. So again, the 50 works pretty well here as well. Here is a resistance various times, here support level, again here breakout, but yeah, it works. There is not that often that swing around this price. And if you get an idea that, and if you get a feeling that this works and you can find clear signals, then this should be okay. And I encourage you to use two different ones, like the 20 and the 50, but you need to try out which time frame works better for you. I normally, as I said, use the 20, the 50, and the 200. Some people like to use the 20, the 50, and the 100. It's to some degree also personal preference, but please always stay consistent. So I hope that was a useful video for you. You now should be able to use moving averages, simple moving averages, in a basic way, and it helps you to understand them. You can use it to identify trade signals, to identify possible entrance areas for trades or exit areas, and crossovers are very important. Right, so I hope you liked the video. If you did, please smash the like button, and if you want to follow me on this journey here, then please subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching, and subscribe, and see you in the next video. Bye.